happened before, replicate it. They've got to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got great confidence having scored the last time out.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And a short pickup here as he'll get across the 10 to the 11-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Okay, work with me here. Make sure I'm clear on this one. Inside their own 10-yard line, and they run a toss play. I know it works, but ordinarily that takes a lot of chutzpah to do something like that because only thing more dangerous is trying to throw the ball in that situation and maybe taking a big loss.
Now a second down, and Winston lost the football. And this will be recovered at least by the offense, but he'll be taken down in the end zone, and that is going to be a safety. And you know, the man who sat in my chair the last few years, he has a theory. These plays, these safeties, they're so rare. Maybe they should be worth more than 2, maybe 4 points.
I think he's got a great point. I really do, Brandon. But I would go ahead and up it to 6. I'm a former defender. Oh. To me, that's like scoring a touchdown.
Easy now. I'll go 4. I don't know about 6.
Come on, come on. Come up to 6.
A lot of points. Short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Gonna throw right side here, complete. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45.
And when an offense is doing a nice job selling the play-action pass, a lot of responsibility shifts to the linebackers. They're the ones up to determine run or pass.
And this is caught. Touchdown, Cleveland. Their dangerous wide receiver, 51 yards. And once again, the Browns are back in front. The fly route works for the TD grab.
And you know what the receivers love to say? If we get even with the defender, we're leaving. And that's exactly what he did, all the way into the end zone. And then he was on the business end catching it once he got over the stripe.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And the last time they had the football, they surrendered 2 points on the safety. And they don't want to do that one again.
No, not at all. It's almost like a bases-clearing double, isn't it? Give up a couple of runs.
Sure.
just messes things up for you offensively. But now they've got to go ahead, take it, set it aside, and move forward.
A first down throw for Winston. That's complete. Middle of the field to Humphreys. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
That was a nicely run slant route. And what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
Offense in a good spot here. 2nd and 2. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And some space here. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
You don't have to be a finished product to show some pretty good glimpses of what could be in this league. And we just saw an example of it on that nice run there. When I looked at him coming out of college, I saw a guy with raw, terrific ability. I couldn't wait to see how it was going to be harnessed and polished up in the NFL. In fact, some people thought he could play a little slot receiver as well as run the football. This guy has the ability to be a big-time player with more seasoning. And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Going again, Winston on 2nd and 10. Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And got a man. It's caught at the 6-yard line. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. Their big-bodied receiver. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Browns are able to strike quickly for six. Now after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Buccaneer offense set to take over again. And two picks thrown here in this first half alone. We'll see how that affects it.
Can't wait to see where his confidence is, because the great ones, they'll throw four or five picks, and while it'll hurt their team, it won't hurt their confidence. They'll think something was just wrong with the ball or the wind or something was funny. It's never about them. That's how they stay so into the moment and into the game.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. One receiver to the left is Evans. On second down, Winston again. He gets it to Humphreys. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
And that was well defended. And as a cornerback, what you're taught when you see a wide receiver screen, either you get underneath the play before the blocking forms, or you're going to have to fight your way through it by getting through some blocking. That was a really nice play there.
We've got a third and 11. Third down, Winston going up top. And oh, Jameis intercepted a third time. Picked off by Super Bowl 49 hero Malcolm Butler. And the Browns getting set to go. And last time the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up. Whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. But they have to be.
And down he goes. A Buccaneer sack. They dial up the corner blitz that time, and it delivers to the tune of a 9-yard loss.
Ohio! Ohio! Here we go! Ohio! Ohio!
Back to throw here. He's going to loft one deep left side here. That's caught inside the 20. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. A big play there. On his way to a monster game. Three first-half touchdowns. And the Browns add six to their lead. And that one makes this a 19-point game. Now, after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
Cut his left. Cut his left. Check nickel, nickel, nickel. Ready, clear, clear.
From the shotgun, it's Winston. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. 15 yards through the air and a first down.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do? You got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end. Take some easier completions.
Okay, interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. Going underneath for Crowell. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. It'll go as a gain of 12. And the Buccaneers are going to have a first down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Super Bowl 49 hero Malcolm Butler. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. He's going to loft one deep left side here. This is caught inside the 15. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. Their dangerous wide receiver as the first half is winding down. And the Browns add on to their lead. And that will bump the lead up to 26. After the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now the Buccaneers offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And Winston lost the football. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. To throw is Winston. He's got his tight end on the corner route. It's complete. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So as they take it over, we step aside. Third down now following the completed pass. Final play of the half here, Winston. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. So we...
Jeez, don't you at least want your guys to get a drink of water? Probably pretty thirsty.
Whatever, your wish, our command. Third quarter now. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Out come the Buccaneers. They'll have it first to start the third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is. Right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But
this is a
real,
I'm doing it though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. The second down throw for Winston. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. So the D-line's going to spread out.
I'm going to show my age here a little bit. We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting like you're so old. You're only 65.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6 foot, 6 inch target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do, and it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up in the top shelf where the kids can't get it. It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
He's a rookie, and you don't want to get hung up on the word potential, but when you see him make catches like that, you keep thinking to yourself, he's good now. He's got a chance to be great with plenty of work.
Third and four. One receiver to the left is Evans. Again, it's Winston. He's got Evans. A gain of 32 that time.
And that's how you throw up a whole heap of yards in a game. You get efforts like that from your receivers. How about him laying out for that catch?
Yeah, excellent. Makes the quarterback look a whole lot better. To the air again with Winston. And he hauls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. Martellus Bennett, his first touchdown on the year. And the Bucs are able to close the gap just a bit. And he's a reliable target. He's more than that, though. Hey, look, I'm not going to say he's the best tight end in the league, but he's solid.
Yeah, because he's able to block, and that's almost a lost art for a number of the tight ends in the league now, because the most popular guys are almost what we call move tight ends, more like receivers, but those guys who can do it all, there's still a place for them in the NFL.
A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, we'll see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time. I mean, that's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
Give them 11 on the gain there, and the Browns are going to have a first down.
And that run was what a lot of people call an explosive run. Gave them good yardage, solid yardage. They feel good about the whole thing, and they did it behind a two tight end set. It's always interesting to watch what offenses want to do with the two tight ends. Sometimes they line them up together for a power set. Sometimes they put one on each side of the line of scrimmage to balance things out. No matter what, though, when you see two tight ends on the field, your first thought is to think of run. In this case, the offense was able to run successfully.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to get hit at the line of scrimmage and driven backwards. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Gerald McCoy is so slippery and elusive in the interior of the defense. I don't care who has the assignment to block him. They usually end up having to take at least two. And most of the time, that's not enough either. Witness that tackle for a loss.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. He's going to float this one deep right side. And this is caught. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. Their big-bodied receiver, 66 yards. And the Browns add 6 to their lead. And he's been a busy man. 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. After the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Buccaneers getting ready to go as they take the field. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard. Well, I guess we just discovered that someone is certainly not going to sit back and just take it in this game, huh?
No, they were trying to get that touchdown back in one shot.
One shot, trying to help out his defense and let the other team know they were coming after him.
Jameis to throw it. And he comes back with one complete. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. And they're going to speed things up here.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
Nothing on that one. It'll be second down.
Brandon, just mark that under the category of just not successful. Trying to throw the ball, just didn't work on that one.
Completed it. No yardage. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Jameis again. And the pressure gets there, and Winston goes down. Jason Pierre-Paul in there to get him, and that's sack number 6 for him on the year. And on third down, the Browns going to go with a nickel set. Third and long for Winston. Under pressure, they got him again. They bring the safety on the blitz, and he busts through to drop him for an 8-yard loss.
Brandon, what I remember most about playing with guys who knew how to...
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. They're going to try for it on fourth. Winston stays out there. They're indeed going. It's Winston. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. Boy, a real head-scratcher there. And the Browns are going to get this thing back. Excellent field position. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
Let's see if they dial it up this drive.
Gerald McCoy is always going to be linked with Ndamukong Suh. They came into the NFL in the same draft class. There's a lot of debate about who is going to be the better defensive tackle. They just do it two different ways. McCoy, more movement, more elusiveness. That allowed him to make the play there for a short game.
They'll look to throw. And he can't hang on. That's definitely going to be one he wishes he had back. Incomplete in the end zone.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big-time drop.
They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. They'll look to throw on third and goal. And this is going to be incomplete. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
Well, they're going to try this thing. They're at the 5, 4th and goal. They're going to go for it. We'll see. Run, probably pass two, both in the arsenal. He'll drop to throw. And this is incomplete. They're turned away on 4th and goal. And the Bucs defense, they'll celebrate the goal line stand. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on 4th, turned it over in their own territory.
but the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold
up. But
he
trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it. Be aggressive, because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Well, now we'll see what his offense can do. Second down following the run. They come out here in the eye. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And some room for him there as he'll take this up to about the 15. 9 yards on the pickup there as he'll be left with third and one. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. And they'll go with a ground attack here. And he'll have the first down as he's up to about the 18. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
Third and one, partner. No need to be fancy there. Just use some force and move forward and pick up the first down.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And this defense continues to give them fits. They just can't get really anything going on the ground, can they?
I love the theme that you just brought up. This defense has been tough all game long against the run. We just saw another example of it there.
They'll try to throw now. Winston. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. And it's third down.
So much of this game is about leverage. We always talk about low man wins in the trenches. Well, it's like that at just about every position. And sometimes, if you lose that leverage and you're losing the battle, just jump up at the line of scrimmage and try and bat the ball away. And that's exactly what happened there.
On third down, Winston. And now here is another interception. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Browns defense has a touchdown. Short throw, pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. On the return now, it's Josh Huff. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. Here on first down, under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Dante Hightower in there to bring him down for a loss of seven.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of...
And my goodness, another interception. A great read, and it's picked off. And they're going to be set up in the red zone at the 15. And the Browns offense back out there ready to take over. And last time, they had it fourth and goal, rolled the dice, didn't get it. Now they've got to put that behind them, try to put together another drive.
Hey, a simple tip of the cap, a nod of the head to the defense. Congratulations, you got us last time. But you didn't hold us the whole time. We got down to position. We were able.
And that's going to be caught for a Browns touchdown. Michael Pruitt, his first touchdown on the year. And the Browns take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash this one in. Now, this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. Now, after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. Here's Huff to return. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. And they'll blow that one up back at the 16-yard line. He lost six there on the first down play. Well, where do you find that one in the playbook, Charles?
You don't. You absolutely don't. And sometimes what happens is guys want to make a big play, and they turn it into a really bad one. Sometimes you're best just to cut your losses and go down. I hope we don't see another play like that. I'll guarantee you the offensive coordinator, he's going to get his play sheet. He can't find it either.
Yeah, big loss there on the pass completion. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. A gain of 32 that time.
Depending on the type of screen called, especially when you're throwing it with one of your wideouts, it's different blocking. Sometimes you get great blocking from the other wide receivers helping you. And how about sometimes getting it from the offensive linemen who sell it like a regular screen pass and then get out.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. That one will set him back nearly 10 yards here on first down on the sack. Second down, Winston. And he finds a man on the crossing route. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance. I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up the block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
And this is taken in at the five. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Mike Evans, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Bucs are able to get a score back. Point after now from Sturgis. And they make the score a little bit more respectable here in our final quarter of play. Ready for the kickoff, and here we go. It's in the air, and this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field, and they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four.
I know the toss play begins with the guy taking the snap and turning around and tossing it to the runner, but where the real intrigue is, can they seal the edge, whether it's an offensive tackle or a tight end in the direction they want to run the football? If they do that, that's the result that you get, that type of a gain. If they don't, oftentimes it's not a very successful play.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there.
Hey, check, check. Three down. Come on!
They'll give it to him right up the gut, and he's going to have the first down at about the 38. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
Everyone understood their role on that play. Third and one. You know, the defensive guys, they're trying to get down and get low and get leverage on the offensive linemen, but they didn't allow that to happen. They created a crease and allowed him to get through for a first down.
So a loss of five, and it'll be second down.
Hey, a lot of points have been scored in this game, but what a nice play by the defense. Stepping up on that one, maybe they'll get things going in their direction after a play like that.
And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. William Golston in on the stop. And barring something unforeseen, this will be the last play of the game. Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking.